Scooby-Doo, where are you when the apocalypse strikes? One of our independent or other publisher kind of books that you guys have enjoyed has been Scooby-Doo Apocalypse, with the end of the world happening and our bunch of our hipster Scooby-Doo gang teaming up to go fight against the end of the world. This is going to be the next couple of issues to see if you guys truly do still want these videos. And if you do, let us know in the comments down below. Let's go find Scooby-Doo! I know it's been a while, guys, but in our last video, we watched the people of the world get transformed into bloodthirsty beasts at the hands of an organization known as the Complex. Though most of the world's population has been converted, there were 4 people and a dog that managed to survive the outbreak. Now, with only themselves to rely on, they must work together to get out of this nightmare and hopefully not kill each other in the process. After their most recent escape, the gang finds themselves at the Nevada Mall Mart, where Shaggy is facing his biggest crisis yet. He has to pee. Fred tells him that's nice, and Shaggy says that they've been holed up here the whole time and all he's been doing is drinking those gallon jugs of ginger beer. A few moments later, Fred asks, "Is that better?" And Shaggy shouts, "You have no idea!" Velma then tells everyone that they have to find a way out of here. Their best bet would be to try and gain access to the roof before they can get a much broader view of their situation. And Daphne says, as much as she hates to admit it, that's not a terrible idea. Velma then leads the group up to the roof access, and when they open up the door, they spot 2 of these monsters sitting there. Velma whispers that they need to go back before they, but Daphne says, "No way, they're not going anywhere." And she takes Velma's laptop and throws it over the edge. The laptop lands and shatters on the ground, causing the 2 monsters to quickly jump after them, giving the gang a chance to actually look at their surroundings. As they look around, they see the monster hordes all around them, and they realize that there is no way for them to get back to the mystery machine, their van. Everyone heads down the stairs and Velma says they need to figure out a way to get a clear path. So everyone grabs something that could be considered flammable. And after stockpiling propane, fireworks, and an assortment of other things, Velma says that if anyone has a deity to pray to, this is going to be the time to do so. Velma then sprays lighter fluid on the ground, bringing it back to their hiding spots and then lights it up. A few moments pass and Daphne tells Fred that she knew that this wasn't going to work. And just as she says that, the flammables explode, blowing a hole through the roof, startling all of the nearby monsters. Daphne shouts to Velma that she almost killed them, and Velma says, "Well, almost doesn't count. Now be quiet or she'll bring the monster's attention to them." Daphne tells her that she doesn't get to tell her what to do. And a monster runs by, with Daphne ducking behind the wall, stating, "Right, getting down, shutting up now." Once the initial waves run past, everyone looks up to see that there are still a few monsters outside. And while the group tries to figure out what to do next, Velma suggests that she should be the one to get there and create a distraction. Scooby runs up telling him, "Uh-oh, right, 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 right." Then he begins to bark as he runs outside by the mystery machine. The monsters begin to chase after Scooby, and Daphne tells them that they need to go help him or they're going to kill him. Velma stops them, telling them that they can't. If they go, they're going to die. Their only hope is getting into the van. As everyone makes a break for it, Daphne looks back, noticing Fred isn't with them. Back inside, Fred is carrying a box of supplies, and he says they need this stuff if they're going to survive on the road. Daphne tries to tell him that they can always find more, and then a monster jumps up from one of the aisles and onto Fred. As he does, the monster pushes down, snapping Fred's leg, and Daphne quickly spins around to shoot the monster's head off. Daphne shouts that she's going to need some help, and Velma runs over to help support Fred while the 2 of them help him into the van. Shaggy tells everyone that they better fasten their seatbelts, because this is gonna be a bumpy ride! As Shaggy speeds out of the parking lot, Velma notices that Dr. Krebs, the owner of the van, neglected to install seatbelts, and Shaggy tells her, "I was not being literal about fastening your seatbelts." A short while later, Velma steps out of the back of the van, and Daphne asks, "How is it?" Velma says that she did the best that she could, but there's a serious break. There's some of the bone piercing out of the skin as she's extremely worried about infection. They're going to need proper tools and drugs to treat this. Shaggy points across the street at a hospital and he says, "How about that? We just gotta hope the beasties aren't crawling around inside of there." Velma tells him that they're gonna have to try. They have to help Fred no matter the cost. And Shaggy sighs, telling him, "Are we really gonna risk everything for Fred and leave Scooby behind? Guess human lives are more important than dogs." Velma says that they would have attempted to try and help Scooby, but they all would have died. Besides, the glasses that Scooby is wearing has GPS on them. He can track her glasses as well, and he can make it back here in no time. A bit later, as everyone begins to head into the hospital, Scooby does in fact make his way back to everyone. The group props Fred up onto a nearby bed, and Velma begins to rummage through the cabinet, stating that they're going to need to set the break. Shaggy says, I don't do well with these sort of things. I once threw up watching Grey's Anatomy. Daphne shouts, telling him that they have been blasting monsters to bloody bits, and this is what he doesn't have the stomach for? And Velma says, actually, Shaggy and Scooby could go look for medical supplies in other rooms. Just grab whatever you can and I'll sort it out. Shaggy hurries out of the room, telling him, no problem. And seconds later, him and Scooby hear the snap of Fred's leg being put back in place and they run out of the room. As they turn the corner, there's another scream and the two jump and Daphne runs out asking, why did you scream? Shaggy says, actually, it wasn't us. That wasn't Fred. Daphne then says, that was a human scream, someone in terrible pain. And Shaggy tells her, or it could be a monster mimicking the sound of a human in terrible pain. Besides, we're the only ones who made it out of the plague alive. Everyone else has been transformed into whatever those things are. Daphne then says, according to Velma, maybe not. Back at the Mall Mart, they found a dead human body, and after a bit of digging around, Velma found that he had a pacemaker. There could be a connection between the pacemaker and the fact that the person who hasn't been mutated by the nanites. Suddenly, there's another scream, and everyone runs outside to regroup. Daphne says that there is someone inside of there. They have to help him. They just can't turn their backs now. And Fred reaches out, stating that they don't know what kind of horrors could be inside. He's not letting her go. Daphne pulls away, telling him, you can hardly stand. Just stay in the van. And Shaggy says, you should have known by now she isn't going to change her mind. As the three head back inside, Scooby leads the way into the room and they turn on the lights and they find a mutilated human body. Shaggy begins to panic and Daphne tells him, be quiet. We're going to have to hurry and find the other survivors. Then there's a second scream and Daphne begins to run up the stairs towards where that sound came from. As they burst into the next room, they find more mutilated bodies scattering the ground. Daphne says, all right. Maybe we should go turn back, and then there's a groan coming out of one of the rooms. She starts charging forward, and Shaggy shouts that she's going the wrong way. Daphne then readies herself by the door and asks Shaggy if he's ready. He tells her, nope, but let's do it anyway. And Daphne slams open the door with her rifle drawn. In front of them is a blue monster in a lab coat, telling them that he's terribly sorry, but no one is to be admitted without an appointment. Shaggy and Daphne stare at the man on the bed with several needles sticking out of his chest, struggling, telling them, kill me, please. The monster looks back at the man, telling him, why would we do that? I'm a physician who swore an oath to never injure or do harm. Daphne points the gun at the monster and he tells her to please lower that and wait outside. I'll be with you in a moment. Shaggy says, maybe we should leave. And Daphne shouts, no way am I letting this doctor torture this helpless human. The monster pulls out a scalpel from his arm and he tells her, you must understand, sometimes pain is required to heal. The rifle goes off, shooting the monster's arm off, and he shouts, what have you done? Code Silver, Code Silver. Daphne asks, what's that? And Shaggy says, that means that there's someone in the hospital with a weapon. I saw it on Grey's Anatomy once. But before they could run, the entire room begins to twist around and the bed begins to suck the man inside of it. Back outside, Fred says that he can't wait any longer. We have to do something. Just then, a window from the second floor is blown out and out comes Shaggy, Daphne, and Scooby. While Scooby and Daphne get down, Shaggy says, after she just shot at the window, everything looks normal again. Velma says that she just wants to make sure. You're telling me that the room came alive? And Shaggy tells everyone, look, it was majorly weird in there, even for us. The next morning in Gartersville, Nevada, the gang wakes up in a house, and Daphne asks, where is Velma? Shaggy tells her that actually she's been up for a while. She snagged a computer from the hospital and is trying to hack the complex's servers. Upstairs, Velma sits on a bed, typing away at the computer when she finally manages to get into the servers. The moment she does, she runs to the back room to throw up. And as she sits back, she mutters to herself, those arrogant, irresponsible, deceitful, self-righteous bastards. The truth is, I have no one to blame but myself, though. If it wasn't for me, none of this would have been happening. While Velma keeps to herself what she found on the servers, the gang continues to travel to California. Once night comes, they all shack up in a motel. And while Velma gets back to work on the computer, she decides that it's time to get some fresh air. As she opens the door, she sees Scooby sitting out front, and after coughing, she asks, what are you doing here? He tells her, I'm worried about you. So she coughs again, telling him, it's very sweet of you. I think I've just developed a minor cough is all. She then tells him that she needs to get someone from the van so he can go ahead and get to bed now. Scooby says, night! And he heads off, and once Scooby's out of view, Velma runs. With one last look at the motel, she leaves into the night, and then back in the motel room, Velma left the laptop on with her access to her findings. And at the bottom of the screen is a note that simply says, I'm sorry. What she discovered changes everything in the Scooby-Doo apocalypse. This is an interesting world, one that has been changed for the worse. Monsters and demons are everywhere, and only the Scooby gang can save the day. Yes, we are leaving it on this cliffhanger, but you can find us next time at the same Scooby time at the same Scooby channel.
Scooby Dooby Doo, where are you?
What is the line?
I don't know.
Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed the Scooby-Doo video. If you do want more, give this video a like, subscribe to the channel, and let us know in the comments down below. Don't forget, you can check out part one right here and other videos brought to you by YouTube, who recommends it to you over here. And I will see you next time right here. Someone learn the lines next time we do that.